It's Mina and welcome to my channel. So today's video I'll be showing you how I start a new project. You can find my previous video about the unboxing of this kit. For the material you will need a piece of Ada fabric. This one is a 14 count. You will need a paper sheet with all the symbols. Or just the TMC colors, depends on which kit you are working on. You will need a pattern, detailed pattern. You will need floss. I have two organizers of floss, one needle of the size of the fabric, and one hoop. I have a plastic hoop where you can adjust with a screwdriver. So you can make it more tight. Inside there is a hole, you can clip the top part with the bottom. So when you will try to tighten the fabric in the hoop, it will be secured. And you will need scissors, pointy ones. These are optional, but I use a needle threader. Cover minders, I mostly use two at the time. Friction pen. I use it because instead of washing your fabric, you can erase the ink with an iron or a straightener. Now you will need to fold your fabric to find the middle so you can start gridding it. Now we have the middle, so you can mark it if you want. And then you can start gridding the first line. Pick up your pattern. You will need to grid it the same way as the pattern. So per square, there's 10 stitches, so count carefully to avoid any mistakes when you'll be working on the project later on. As you can see on my pattern, the last row at the right and at the bottom, there's no 10 stitches of square but rectangle of 5 stitches, but that's fine, just stick to your pattern and not mine. On my pattern, the middle is the 50 right there, as I'm showing on the picture. So once you have done that, you will grid it on the fabric. Now you can start gridding your fabric. It's really easy, you just have to follow the points and then just go straight to the bottom. Here, as you can see, I've made a mistake. I told you at the start of the video, I'm using a straightener to remove the line that I did a mistake with, and just erase it, pretty easy. Now you can start over again and grid your fabric with that mistake. If there is, you can always erase it. Take again your pattern and then grid it again until everything is gridded, and count the square exactly there is on the pattern. And then count on your fabric to be sure that you're not making any mistakes. That's how it looks like when you grid everything. You should serge the side by folding your fabric and a sewing machine. Now we're going to place the hoop on the fabric. So make sure to tighten the fabric enough. It will be way easier to work with and less messy, so the stitches will be neat. So adjust the fabric by pulling it, like I do, and I adjust it also with a screwdriver to make sure it's really tight. Pull the fabric at the back to avoid the fabric to let go, and then to make sure that the fabric is tight, tap on it, and if you can hear a sound, then the fabric is well placed. Now I'm gonna place cover minders, place two of it, and a little trick I do, I place an extra magnet at the top so I can just put my needle threader. This step is optional, it's really simple to set up. You just have to place the whole stand between the top of the hoop, then use the right screw to fix it. I just see that, but I've made a mistake. The little screw should be at the right and not at the left. I just attached a picture that showed the right placement. I bought this stand on AliExpress, I will put the link in the description box. Pick up your pattern, depending where you want to start, but I'm gonna start in the middle, so count the exact square there is on the pattern, and then you can start stitching it. This is optional, pick up your chart and look at the color floss that you're going to choose to start with to avoid mistakes. Every one thread has 6 smaller threads, as you can see, you just need one at a time. So to separate them, you just have to hold the other threads and pick one, and you just have to pull it. It's pretty simple. Now we are going to need a needle threader, unless you don't have one, so you can just do it by hand. You will need to fold the thread in two and then thread it to the needle. So now we have two threads on the needle as we are working on 14 count Ida. Make sure the end of the floss are equal, and then now I'm going to show you how to start your thread. It's called loop start, it's pretty simple. Now just find the first stitch. When you find your stitch, put the needle into the top right corner. The loop should be at the top. Then put your needle at the bottom left corner, pull the thread. Then put the needle into the loop. Pull it. Then put again the needle into the left bottom corner. Now you have your first stitch. So for me, I have to make half stitch, and I will show you later how to make a full stitch. Now you can just stitch following the pattern until the thread is finished, and then I will show you how to end your thread. To end your thread, put the needle into the middle of the stitch, put the needle back in the middle. So now you have like a line, and then put your needle at the very top of the center of the stitch, like this, and then just put your needle back in the middle, and now you have your thread secured. Either way, put it through a stitch and then cut it, or you can just leave it there and then later on cut it off. Now I'm going to show you how to do a full stitch. We are going to do a loop start, and I'm going to make two half stitch and then after end the full stitches. Now put your needle at the bottom right corner. And then into the top left corner. So every stitches I do it this way. You can also do all the way around, but it depends to you. Every four stitches has to be going to the same direction. Now I'm going to end my thread, as I have no other pink color around. And then I will show you another method, how to do a loop start after you still have some thread left. Now we are going to do the other method of the loop start. Put the thread somewhere near your stitch. Then put the needle at the top right corner, pull it, and then go back to this corner, leave a loop, go to the bottom left corner, pull it, go through the loop, then go back to the left bottom corner. Now you can just do your full stitch and then end your thread the same way as I showed you. I just noticed but my half stitches are facing the wrong side. It should be facing the left side. But don't worry, I fixed it already. After I record the video, I just see that. I'm very sorry, don't make the same mistake as me. That's it for this video. I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to interact with me in the comments. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye!